Hi folks, what do you get when you put two big multimeters together? The answer is simple. This. Isn't it a very cute little multimeter? I bought it just because I had thought it is a very cute multimeter and a handy thing to put in your pocket or in your bag if you are not at home and want to have a multimeter on hand with you. It's only 12 euros or something like that, and it comes with some accessories I will show you. It comes with this bag, a user manual, not that you need one for this. Tiny little test leads with tiny little probes. They got the caps on it in case you want them in a higher CAT rating. And I've measured the insulation resistance of the leads. They're not bad, not bad at all. And a thermocouple is used with it. It's delivered with it, also handy. It can do volt AC and DC, millivolt AC and DC. It has a beeper, and you can, by pushing the yellow button, you can go to the range it has. That is ohm. And this is the beeper, easy with the caps off, and even more easy if you put the plugs in, otherwise it would be the first remote beeper. It's not fastest, but it's more than fast enough just for a multimeter you have on the road. And it's very usable. It also has a capacitor function, diode test. It can measure heads frequency and duty cycle. It has current and millicurrent, milliamperes, and it can measure temperature. I will first show you some of the performance, because it really surprised me how well the calibration was of this little thing. It's really great. I will show you. This is the millivolt position, and here it's measuring 100 millivolts, so it's one digit off. When I tested it this afternoon, it was spot on. But it will have a certain tempo, and I just put the calibrator on. I didn't take time to warm it up, but that doesn't matter very much because the resolution of the calibrator is so high. The digits that will make a difference when it's cold are far out of the reach of this little meter. I can go up a step, and we get 200 millivolts. Two counts off, one count off still. Very, very good for such a small meter, I think. It goes to 500, so I can turn it up a bit, and it's 4.99. The response is quicker as I would have expected for such a small meter. I will go up one range, and then we got 5 volts, and it takes little to rest the last digit. Here it's 2 digits off. That means the temco is not all too good, because this afternoon it was 2 or 3 degrees warmer here inside. So, and at that point it was really spot on. It was really like, man, such a small meter and such a cheap meter, and then this performance. Although it will not say that it will keep its calibration for a longer time. It's easy to make a meter that is spot on right after you build it, but the trick is to make it like that if it over 5 years still performs like this. And something like a Keithley or a Keysight multimeter will do that, plus or minus a few digits or so. These sort of meters, if they last that long, it's just on the jump from 8 to 9. I can show all the ranges, but I've tested that this afternoon. They're all like this, so that's great. Won't bore you with all the tests that I can do. I will do the current if you like, more interesting is AC volts, because it is true RMS meter. This one, this calibrator goes to 1 megahertz in frequency, but it's still a sine wave signal. The problem for true RMS meters is often they're not sine waves to measure them very well. So at this moment we got a signal of 100 hertz, 2.5 volts, and the meter is showing 2.5 volts. That is very nice. But I can go up in frequency. At this moment it is 1 kilohertz, and it's 8 counts off, but not bad. Then we go to 10, and at 10 kilohertz it's over. He doesn't understand a thing of it, and he gives up. And a good true RMS meters, the real good ones, go to over 100 kilohertz. Like Keithley goes, Keithley 2000 goes in some ranges up to 1 megahertz, and that's real good. But 1 kilohertz is not too shabby for a small meter like this. But remember, this is always sine wave. Just to make it complete, this is my dog is thinking. The multimeter is beeping to him. Just a moment. So I told her there was a pussycat in the garden, and now she's gone. This is the milliamps, and it is 25 milliamp in the milliampere input of the meter. And it also has an amp input that goes up to 10 amps. It's in the same rate of accuracy as the rest, so no problems there. Also check the temperature, that was also within 1 or 2 degrees. It's always difficult to test it very well, and normally take a dry well for that, but that's for calibration thermometers. And again, I have a calibration thermometer calibrator here also, so I can calibrate the meter and the probe, the K probe. But there's not so much use for that. It's more than enough for just purpose of a quick probing to see if something gets hot or something gets warm. If you want it really, really accurate, then you have to pay a lot of more money than 12 euros. There's a hold function for backlight. The backlight is only a few seconds on. That's much too short. And what function of hold is here? Yeah, I don't know. The nice holds are that you measure and then beep, and it takes the reading, so you don't have to look away from where you're measuring. But this is just to note it for a 6-digit multimeter or so. It's sometimes handy because you want to note the value, and then you can see all the numbers, but not for a thing like this. A little bit crazy. Oh, this took a while. I took the meter like this to pull the plugs, and then I pressed the hold button without knowing it. So I was setting up the calibrator, but nothing on the display. It was just a problem. If I short the test leads, then you see that there is a 0.3 ohm resistance. And it's not only the cables, because the resistance of these cables is much lower than this. It's more in the range of 0.03 ohms instead of 0.3. So the rest is in the meter. There is no relative function on it, and so the 3 is already a fault. And I have to put the right buttons. So here we have 10 ohms, and that's 10.3, so that is exact 10 ohms. 100.4, it drops to 3, still good, or spot on. This is 1K, here the 3 counts is outside of the display. And then we go to 10K, spot on, one digit. 100K, 99.9, and this is 1 mega ohm, also one digit. And the last, it can do 10 ohm, there is also a 100 ohm range, 100 meg ohm range, but it's outside of the meter. So, I think not bad for such a small meter. So, let's take it apart. First the screwdriver. I won't go into the mechanical build things like the trays and so, because it's way outside of the price for a good meter. It is a nice insert to AAA batteries. They don't come with the meter. I can look what the meter is using in current. It's a bit how you're doing, because I'm have to keep the probe in one hand, but the result is not very bad. If you see it, if you can read it, it's 1.2 milliamps in the voltage range. It will be possibly a bit more in the resistance range, but not too bad. It will do a long time with the battery probably. So, and this is in the ohms position. Then you can see how it what it uses. It's measuring the source resistance, the shunt resistor of the Brymen at 100 ohm, and it's generating 387 microamps. Probably it is not manual ranging, so maybe in higher range or lower ranges it takes a bit more. Also important, the voltage it puts out in ohms mode, and it's just over half a volt, so it won't damage equipment with that. And if we take it to the continuity, then it goes just over 1 volt. I measure the resistance of the test leads by pushing them on some metal surface with the tips just next to each other, so I have the resistance from tip to tip, because it's not very interesting if you measure it like that, because you don't measure in a circuit like that often. It doesn't make all too much of a difference, but I will show you the meter I use for this, my Keithley, my beloved Keithley. So here you see the result on the Keithley. It's just over 1/10 of an ohm, and 1/10, 0.114 ohm. That's not great, but it's not not unusual, of not really bad. I've seen test leads that are much worse. Just to compare it, here I have two very small test leads from Pomona. They are very nice, with very sharp tips and very thin wire, the micro probes. But the downside of that, the cables are much longer, is that it's 0.223 and a bit ohm. So a double as the other test leads. But the cables are also almost twice as long and twice as thin. If you take a decent normal cables, only one I get on hand here are Flux. These are much better, these are Keithley. Put them on the same way like before, and then you see they are 0.051 ohm. So that makes a lot of difference for some measurements. And these are the cheap Keithleys. These are not even the high end or so. These came with the meter, with Keithley. They look very cheap. They are not even silicon wire, but the resistance as well, and they have the highest insulation resistance from all my meters, because I always test them on leakage. Also tested those little ones from the meter we're now talking about, and it was not bad. It was well over what is stated for. Put them on a paper. They were 0.6 times 10 to the 11th ohm, so a 1000 volt, measured 1000 volts. So I don't guarantee that it will keep that forever, but at least as they are new, they are safe. 10 amps I didn't test, because who goes measuring 10 amps with such a small thing like this. By the way, the current after the capacitance meter surprised me, because I did a review of this one here, and I liked it so much I bought it, and that has troubles measuring capacitors under 1N, and this one, it's the beeper, this diode test, this is NFs. And I got here a 10 picofarad. I got the real capacitance standards, but it's much too much work to get them out. This is around 10 p plus minus some femto farads, and it's measuring it as 8 NF, so it's not bad. And this afternoon it was exact at 10, and this is 100 NF. For 100 PF, this is 1 NF, and this is 10 and a bit, 10.1 NFs. So it's not bad for such a small, cheap meter. The one I'm looking now, it is 93.52, so that's 30 counts of it. It's not bad. But the reason I took this plate was to test the diodes, because the voltage was higher. This is 0.5. If we take 2 in series, it's 1.158, and if we take 3, it's 1.69, and if we take 4, it's 2.182. So it the surprise from the inside. There are a lot of reviews over this meter, so we'll take it short. I was not planning for a review of this, but it turned out I like making these reviews. And this is a cute little meter for that. So. It looks like it's rubber on the pictures, but it isn't, it's just plastic. Very cheap feeling plastic. And I think it's afraid to show its inners, because it doesn't cooperate. Come. Yeah, and how do you get it open? Simple. No. And the last one, the inside. I already seen this on a YouTube, other YouTuber. Aren't they cute? They are such small. They are just cute to see. I thought about placing bigger ones, but what the heck? I don't ever use it for that. So I think I can look hours at it. It's just like a miniature meter, and they miniaturized really everything. The buses are split, and it's not very good, but Okay. Hey, it's 12 euros and you got two fuses, and there are sand filled fuses too, and some nice MILF resistors. There is a PTC. Of course, the multimeter chip is under a blob. And you got some protection diode and the beeper. There's more diodes of transistors there. There are no potentiometers to adjust things, but I already saw it on other channels. There is a range button, is it? And there are people who say you can make a relative button too. I think that's on the other side. I don't bother to open it because then the zebra stripes often get loose and I don't get it together again. It's a cute little mini shunt. It's really a baby multimeter, and like real babies, it's not very sturdy. You have to be gentle with them. Little baby multimeters don't. There's enough serious stuff in this branch already. Electronics, this is just fun. If you use this for some industrial work, you deserve it to fry your hands, because you should know you not use this kind of things for it. So it's back together again, and we got the stand that is not to say how sturdy it is, all but, and the screw. I first have to do the stand and then the screw. Screw it, and that's all, folks, for today. So, and it still works, but I wouldn't expect a difference.